Hi and welcome. Today we will look at how we can use the space, first of all, when you are rehearsing. We will also have a look at status in the room and on tempo. So now we are in the staging process of a manuscript. And of course, the manuscript doesn't describe where you are in the room. So you have to be aware of this. In theater, we divide the stage in 9 different squares, you can say. And I have used these papers to make you aware of each of these squares. So here you have the front, and you have the middle, and you have the back. And of course, you have left, you have middle, and you have right. Normally, if you are not aware of this, all the actors will move around and take maybe all the space at the same time. But that doesn't show the character, because different character, they have different favorite areas. So this is not about democracy, where everyone is moving in the same area all the time. So this is something you can use, both when you are lighting, of course, but now when you are rehearsing. Let's say that one character has been told not to move from this favorite position, because outside of here, he or she will not feel so comfortable. So maybe this is an area for this character, while other characters might have only this corridor to move in, and this would be like that. So there will also be like a distance between the character in the corner down there and this character. They will probably never meet. That means they have to use this kind of distance when they are communicating. And maybe you have a third character that is using another kind of position. Maybe only this is allowed for that character. So now you have 3 characters, they are moving in different spaces of the stage. This creates a kind of a tension. When they all of a sudden breaks out from the box they are standing in or the space they are in, that will be a very obvious turning point, when someone has been standing like this all the time and then all of a sudden start to move around. Different positions means also different status. You can say some positions are more strong than others. Normally we say that this middle position is stronger, and to move forward like this, talking like what I'm doing right now, is stronger than if I was standing on the side doing the same kind of movements. This is not a new thing for someone who is a teacher or a lecturer. You know about these kind of positions in the room. And instead of turning your back to the audience, you have to move probably like this to keep the contact. So status now in the room. Let's say if I have a position like this in this room, and I freeze it like a statue, most of you will say that is probably a low status person. And we approach rooms in different ways, depending if we are familiar to the room or if it's a new room for us. So if you see an actor entering the space like this, you will probably think that this actor is at home or in some kind of comfortable environment. If you see someone entering the room hesitating, and maybe just take one step in and have a look, that will give you the sign that this person is not comfortable in the room or is very, very careful entering. So this is important to think about. To think about how you approach the stage as a character. Third thing is the tempo. I have already showed you the difference between a slow tempo and the fast tempo. I borrow this kind of technique from the dance and movement training that I have been doing, where you talk about tempo zero as something that is not moving at all. And tempo seven is the highest speed you can have without running. And all between the zero and the seven is possible. And most character, if they don't think about this, they will create a tempo three. That means every actor on stage will move in the same tempo. And that doesn't create the tension that we are looking for. We have to have different tempos and be aware of this. And tempo is not only about walking around, it is doing things. You can wash the dishes with tempo three or seven. It will give you different signals to the audience. They will understand you differently, depending on the tempo you are using. If I want to tear these kind of papers now, if I use tempo one, it will probably mean something differently if you do it in tempo seven. So activities, not only walking, but activities like this, has to have a specific tempo, depending on the character and what you want to express. So today I have give you three different kind of ideas how to start to approach the stage and how you can think about tempo, think about status, and think about how we are using the space in different ways. That is now the end of the 10th episode. Next time we will talk about reflections and feedback again. So, see you then.